Alright guys, MarkBoy316 here with another video, and today's gonna be a movie review, and this was requested by Indie Wisdom Reloaded, and I reviewed the movie They Live. Great freaking action movie, a lot of action, great stuff. And what you don't know about this movie is it's by John Carpenter, but it says written by Frank Armitage, and Frank Armitage is actually a character in the movie. It's not, he wrote it under an alias. That's kind of cool little fact there. But it's about Piper here, who plays John Nada, which you never hear his name actually mentioned in the movie, which is kind of weird. And he plays a drifter, and he meets up with this guy named Frank, obviously. And he gets a job as a construction worker, and they're in this shanty town, and they're working there. And then the police come by and bulldoze the shanty town, and the church is all like demolished and stuff too, and he finds this box of glasses, and he puts a pair of glasses on, and he gets rid of the box and puts the rest of the glasses in the dumpster, hides them in there, and he's just walking in the city and stuff like that, and all of a sudden he puts the glasses on, he sees signs saying consume, obey, breathe, stuff like that, and he's just thinking what the hell's going on, and come to find out that all of a sudden he starts looking at some people and he sees that people have like faces of aliens and stuff like that, and he doesn't quite know what to believe. And then they're basically these aliens that come by, and they're trying to tell the people of this of in the world or in the city that they have to obey, consume, abide by their rules and stuff like that. And everything he looks, all the billboards, all the signs, the cans in the supermarkets, everything has that those words on it. Obey, consume. The money that they're using, same thing. Has their consume, obey. He sees that everywhere. The subliminal messages everywhere, and they're trying to he's trying to figure out what's going on. And then he meets Frank here in the alley to get his paycheck from the construction work, and Frank doesn't believe him either, that he sees the aliens and stuff, and they have this big brawl, about a good 5 to 6 minute brawl. You see Piper doing back suplexes and gut-wrench suplex, big fights. That was actually a pretty cool fight scene. They picked a good fight scene to have with a wrestler, so it was good he was a wrestler that he could do that. And finally he forces him to put the glasses on, finally gets the glasses on him, and he starts to believe Piper that the aliens are here. And they have to try to find their source of power and try to stop them. And it's a very cool movie, a lot of good scenes. I like one line in there, he's there. I came here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum. That's an awesome freaking line right there. They said they actually took that phrase from his wrestling career, because the director, John Carpenter, had written down, Piper carried the notepad with him, and he had written down some promos he had done in wrestling and stuff. And it was kind of cool. And that's where he got that line from. And then another place, one of the security guards asked him, do you have a pass? Do you have a pass? Yeah, it's right here. They start shooting him and stuff. That's pretty cool. And awesome stuff. But if you want a great movie, sit down, about an hour and a half runtime. Came out in 88, November 4th, I do believe, of 88. Yep. Great freaking movie. I highly recommend you check that out. And the cover is pretty cool too, because you got one cover, and then you can turn it around and have the other cover. That's cool. I like that. But it's a great, fantastic movie. I highly recommend it. I'm not gonna say how if they end up finding their power source or what their how they get rid of the aliens. You don't know. But very awesome stuff. I highly recommend you check that out. You'll love how the movie ends. Awesome stuff. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.